Whenever such resistive networks are used, always care has to be taken for power dissipation. How much is the power dissipated and what is the heat generated? Plus, due to this heat generation, self-heating, what will happen to the sensor measurements? So for that, heat sinks and the ambient temperature limitations, they are all have to be placed, to be in place. Now, another mechanism is by integration. Here, the op-amp circuits in integrator mode are used. Now, what is this integrator mode mean? Whenever you sense the current, this current is integrated and converted to voltage using an integrator circuit. Now, regular integrators and the RC networks we have seen, or even in filters, how exactly the current or voltages are converted from one to another, we have seen. Similarly, here also in op-amps, if electrometers are not suitable to use, maybe for different reasons, cost could be one of the reasons, or the complexity in the circuit, or maintenance of the circuit. Because of that, if electrometers are not used in the circuit, under such cases, the current sensors, they are measured by integration. Here the current is converted to voltage using the current to voltage converter, that the voltage is available at one of the integrator end. This is amplified and used for further blocks. So here, current to voltage converter is to measure small currents by integrating them. You can see here, there is a circuit where a simple capacitance is connected of proper value and two switches are used. When S1 is closed and S2 is open, when S1 is closed, S2 is open, whatever current is coming here, you all know it cannot enter this device, so it comes to this capacitor end. That the op-amp is ideal. Now, why the op-amp is ideal, we are using this word? Because if the current enters the device, then no current flows into this, because as the time passes, this acts like an open circuit. But as soon as you switch on, we know in transients, it acts like a short. So the current, entire current, assuming that this is ideal, flows here. So even if it is very small current, it flows into through this, and here it is available as the voltage. Now, how it is available as voltage? You can see here the switch S2 is open still. So when S1 is closed, here the current is available, and you can see here this is the graph. Immediately at T interval, this offset voltage VIO is available, and with this shift, this much voltage is available here. If there is no offset voltage, this graph would start from zero. Again, for this also, one has to take care of the offset voltage by any one of the methods like used in chopper or auto zero amplifiers. We have to use that and reduce that offset voltage to zero and integrate this current into voltage. Now you can see here what is the voltage across C will be, the voltage across C will be across the open switch. If you measure, one possibility is measure it across the open switch, whatever the charges are there, okay. Otherwise, once it charges, close the switch so that the entire current flows here, that you can measure. So any one possibility, you can go ahead. So what is the voltage available here after the integration? 1 by C into integration of 0 to tau is the interval over which this switch S1 is closed. So over this interval, S1 is closed and the current flows here. So II into T. So for how long this is present? So depending upon that, the integration takes place and your voltage across this capacitor is available. This we have seen even in transients. How exactly the initial value can be measured using integration. Similar technique is employed here. So the input current is constant during T interval. Then what will happen if the current is constant? If the current is changing, then your integration, this works over the interval T if it is changing. If it is constant, what will happen over T? Then II divided by C into whatever is the interval, this gives you the voltage developed here. So this current is converted to its voltage equivalent using the integration method. Supposing there is input offset voltage. These two equations hold good when there is no input offset voltage. But practical cases, if the input offset is not reduced to zero, under such cases, what is going to be your equation? So there is this. So this has to be subtracted from the output. Simply what we are doing, the output voltage is equal to II plus IN is what? Here it is connected to the inverting terminal and inverting terminal has the bias current IN. So these two currents are added, II plus IN. IN is the current which is there as biasing current at the inverting terminal. And IP is the current available at non-inverting terminal. So here the signal is coming to the inverting terminal. So what we are doing is II is the input or the sensor current plus IN is the current which is there for the inverting terminal, the bias current at the inverting terminal over the interval tau divided by C and minus this is the care taken to input offset voltage, assuming that certain input offset voltage is available. So this is what is the total output voltage available for small currents by integration method. Now, whenever we are designing electrometers, certain care has to be taken. So this we will deal in the next class. What type and what material should be used and how the impedance has to be increased. All those factors we'll see in the next class.